Hey guys, today I'm going to talk to you about how to jump down to a specific section on a longer web page. For Learning Module 4, one of the requirements is to create a list at the top of your page with a bunch of links that go down to all the different sections of your page. The book talks about how to do this on page 150 if you prefer reading. Obviously you should have read that for your assessment, but just in case you need a reminder of where that is. They don't name these types of links in particular, but sometimes I've heard them referred to as jump links or anchor links. So I have my learning module for assignment over here, and I prefer to start with my list of links. So I've created a link, and in each href, I've created a hashtag with a unique ID after it. So each one of these is unique to something else on the page. And right now when I click on these links, they don't do anything. So we have to create a reference further down on the page. So in the first element of the section that I want to link to, I'm going to add an ID attribute, and it's going to match that href attribute without a pound sign or a hashtag. So I'll save that, refresh, and now that jumps down. We could do this for all of the sections on our page. And so the domain name ideas looks like it jumps down to this random spot after hosting company 3. This will happen if your page is shorter or the sections are shorter and your page just doesn't have anywhere to scroll past that. So to double check it, I'll shrink up my browser and then hit that link so you see that it does actually go there. That was something that was kind of frustrating for me when I first learned these. I thought they didn't work, and then I realized that, you know, it was because the page wasn't long enough. I have a top link. So you'll notice that I have a top link, but I never put an ID in here. Modern browsers do seem to just realize that the hashtag top href is supposed to go to the top of the page, which is helpful. But I would make sure that you add an ID to the top of your page just to make sure that browsers that don't do that for you automatically still end up at the top of the page. So that's basically how you create links down to the sections of your page. In real world situations, you would do this on like an FAQ page. A lot of designers are creating one page websites, so this is how they link down to all those different sections of the website. The last thing I want to show you is how to link to a section of another page. So for this, we'll just pretend that I have a multi-page website, not just this one page. And so say I have a web hosting resources section on a new page. So I would type newpage.html as if that was the actual link. And at the end of that, you add your hashtag to that section on the page. So if I had a newpage.html with an ID on it that went to a web hosting resources, when I click on this link, it'll go to a new page, but it also jumped down to that section. So just if you want to do that, make sure your link works in the first place, and then you can add your hashtag on to the end of that. So if you have any questions, contact your instructor through email or the discussion board or through Blackboard messages, whichever they prefer. And good luck on your Learning Module 4.